Cleveland police officer mistakenly shot and killed 12-year-old Tamir Rice in November 2014 under this gazebo. His death made national headlines, and the city of Cleveland wanted this reminder of the case destroyed.
They fought the city of Cleveland to save the gazebo.
Now, years later, the place where he lost his life has found a new home in Chicago.
There are cities that have faced a lot of the same issues in terms of violence and in terms of police brutality. And so outside of the city of Cleveland, we think Chicago is the next best place.
After being disassembled in Cleveland, the steel beams made their way 5 hours west to the Stony Island Arts Bank.
It gives the black community and America as a whole the opportunity to come around it, remember Tamir's life, heal, and have a dialogue around race and police brutality.
Today, the Rebuild Foundation unveiled the installation.
It's a difficult thing to move physical objects, physical objects matter.
The museum hopes the gazebo will be a place to meet and reflect, a landmark symbolizing police brutality and the experience of black people in America.
It's an incredible moment to all come together and remember a life, an important life.
Now, the museum says this likely will only be a temporary home for this gazebo. It likely won't be here permanently. However, while it is here, they do expect to keep it outside, and they anticipate that it will withstand the Chicago weather, certainly because it's meant to be outside and it lived for so long in Cleveland.